Have you ever wondered how to use this Korg Nanokontrol Studio in Premiere Pro? Well, here's how. What's up, guys? So a while back, I purchased a Korg Nanokontrol Studio to use when I'm playing around in lighting software. But then I thought, wait, I edit a lot of videos. I should be able to use this in Premiere Pro. So after a bit of research, I found out how to set up this MIDI controller to be compatible with Premiere Pro. Before I tell you how to set this up, here's a quick rundown of the Nanokontrol Studio. The Nanokontrol is a reasonably compact and portable controller, making it easy to take on the go. It features 8 faders, 8 knobs, and 32 buttons, as well as a shuttle wheel and transport buttons for controlling playback. And a bonus is it has Bluetooth. So if you lose the cable, you should be able to survive. Let's get into how we set this up for Premiere. First, plug in your MIDI controller. Make sure it's turned off at the back. Open up Premiere Pro, select the Preferences menu, go to Control Surfaces, Add Device, then select Mackie, press OK. Then what you're going to want to do is hold the Set Marker and Record button on the MIDI controller while it's being turned on with the switch at the back. You will need to hold these for about 5 seconds. And then boom! You can now control your audio levels in Premiere Pro simply by pushing around faders. This will default to work with a track mixer, which only affects the individual tracks in your sequence. But if you go to this little burger menu and select at the bottom, toggle Control Surface Clip Mixer Mode, and toggle this switch to allow you to create keyframes on the individual clips. This also allows you to control the playhead with the shuttle wheel and stop and start playback, which is a great bonus. Be sure to like and subscribe if this video helped you out, and check out this video on another incredible device to use in Premiere Pro. Cheers, guys, I'll see you on the next one.